Dominating all distant horizons, Uncompaghre Peak boasts a prominent high point towering above all in the San Juan Mountain Range. At 14,309 feet, the high-altitude mountain lays claim to being the sixth highest peak located within the state of Colorado. Bold views of the mountain will surely chill the vigorous hiker with its fearsome appearance. Uncompaghre maintains exclusive bragging rights among the above 14,000-foot peaks, with its stunning rock mound summit suspended high in the thin-air Colorado sky. The allure to challenge the high mountain summit will surely leave you with a newfound understanding of its elite 14er status held within this very special hike. Our journey begins at a turnoff following the Nelly Creek drainage about 5 miles from Lake City, Colorado. The rough four-wheel drive road meanders about 4 miles with an immediate rock-laden route. Smoothing out through numerous aspen groves, the narrow passage climbs higher and higher with few perception points. Brief glimpses of a small yet spectacular waterfall sidestep from the road will be sure to set the stage with mounting isolation. Utilizing a high-clearance vehicle will tremendously aid and reduce your time frame needed to access the remote wilderness trailhead. About a half mile from the road's end, a panoramic view becomes evident within a comfortable, flat-based field with numerous spots to camp. With the ever-changing weather, this may prove to be the perfect camping spot within the field's sheltering walls. At the trailhead a short distance up the road, you receive your first glimpses to the high mountain summit peering out from the tree-sloped hillside. It is sure to provoke your excitement. Staged at 11,500 feet, you immediately cross the wilderness boundary. This will be the start point of your 4-mile trek to stand upon Uncompaghre's summit. A short walk through the trees quickly ends with an open view, teasing your curiosity as to what lies ahead. This tends to be a well-used corridor for the animals of the forest as they depart the upper slope basin. Treading lightly here may reward one with their presence. As distant back views begin to unfold, the changing forward landscape finds you following the creek with an upward expanding horizon. Your first full-fledged view of the incredible mountain will surely capture all your inner attention. Trekking in this newly staged dream, inner thoughts will be forgotten with the unfolding beauty before your eyes. As I captured myself at this point on the trail, I can still recall the imposing height of the mountain as it completely overcame me. A newly found attitude will readjust your steps as you cross a rock slide area that continues to be a threat from high up on the hillside. You will be forced to channel your inner strength towards a heavier stride as the reality of your hike becomes evident. The now lower end of the valley begins to surround you as you begin to venture up a slanting hill. With hopes for a better overlook, the trail switchbacks with a steepening jolt, but without much distant perception. This is the beginning of the first noticeable altitude gain and will begin to set your pace. As the expanse of the upper basin becomes revealed, concentration on the downward view becomes irrelevant. Miles of alpine tundra lie in a bowl, with the trail dissecting its center. To the left of the basin, an impassable, immense crushed boulder field. After spending the first 3/4 of a mile down lower, the wide open expanse of the basin finds your focal point on the immense peak in the distance. The now hollowed out trail will be sure to lead you forward. Backdrop glances will bring about a newfound reality at this point. Unmistakably, you are now at the edge of timberline. The thin air now becomes evident and at times undeniable. Scanning the openness, you will be sure to find a peace not attainable within our low-altitude existence. Methodical footsteps will be paused as you take in the unique basin panorama. To stand in this secluded ecosystem and attempt to understand the severe conditions it is subjected to will taunt my mind forever. A lower switchback trail leads into the Big Blue Creek Valley just up over the saddle. While the continuing trail remains end-capped by the monumental 14er. Continuing my advance, I felt I had crossed a line into a different and strange world. Chilling thrills filtered through me as I lay witness to a final glimpse of summer while being overshadowed by the stark contrast of the browning hillside beyond. The towering massive mountain will magnetically now begin to draw you in. Transfixed on the timberline trees far below, the now alien setting will kindle a slight sense of fear with its high altitude expanse. The reality of solitude will tend to creep inside you. Yet as I lay witness to my presence at the mountain base, the human existence perceivable on the ridgeline above replenished my addiction to summit fever. Angling to the far left of the basin, you continue the assault towards the ridgeline near its farthest edge. Although it seems you are hiking away from the mountain, you begin to stage yourself along the hillside that separates you from Matterhorn Basin. The trail now meanders, becoming loose and rocky.
Uncompaghre rising up behind me right here. You can see the colorful red bands of, I would call it granite, some kind of a granite in it. And that's actually somewhat the summit. It kind of rolls up behind it. But this is probably about 12,800 feet and making some good time and getting closer to her.
Sidestepping along the far reaches of the basin, you find yourself on a flattening grassy knoll with a stepped up perception point. With an about face, the rolling hillside begins to reveal the staggering trail along with heightened viewpoints. The serrated horizon begins to become exposed. Opposite basin ridgelines drop away, revealing hidden, isolated areas difficult to venture into. Refocused on the tattered steepening trail, a couple of rest stops deposit you at the end of the upper overlook ridge. At this point of your hike, you realize the viewpoint standard begins to become exceptional. Hiking along the windy exposed ridge, Uncompaghre becomes the prime focal point once again. Yet as you traverse along, the overlooks are difficult to ignore. It is common to have high winds ripping along this ridge.
Talk about a view out behind me. You can see 14er and 13er Matterhorn, Wetterhorn. Little notch off to the side of the ridge. Kind of windy, whipping across the edge right here. I kind of found a little calm spot that's not too bad. One spectacular view. All the way up.
The The stroll down the ridge will cause you to pause, reflecting on your path of travel left behind. While the overlooks cast a permanent impression of picture-perfect scenery impossible to pass up, Wetterhorn and Matterhorn will be sure to deadlock your stride. As a couple, their beauty is unsurpassed. As you stumble past the final gap while looking off the ridge, a rising anticipation will push you past the 13,000 foot level.
Coming off the shelf, you end up going up what I call the wall, which is a little bit steeper and definitely winds you down. That's all I have to say.
At this point of my hike, I began to seriously question my reason as I continued on with my 30-pound camera gear-infested load. I refer to this section of the trail as the wall for two reasons. First of all, the trail traverses an extremely steep section crisscrossed by a series of switchbacks. Secondly, you sense your slowing footsteps attempting to convince you it's becoming impossible to lift your foot forward. I absorbed the rising views as I stumbled away the pains. As you continue to gain altitude, the trail falls away below you. The last few steps to the top of the wall are without a doubt breathtaking. Your dizzy consciousness evokes a dreamy sensation as you absorb the expanding horizon. A drop jaw view will be sure to halt your footprints. As the high altitude stage becomes set, with viewpoint after spectacular viewpoint, you are sure to be pushing the buttons on your camera. A lengthy pause at this vista is highly recommended. From here, the hike changes drastically. You begin an airy traverse around the side of an intimidating loose rock upper shelf. Enjoy your last boot imprints on the hard-packed trail, as the terminology of travel is all about to change. The hike no longer exists. The climb is about to begin. Rumbled and crushed footing now draws all your attention, unless you plan to leave your bones on the side of the mountain. It's imperative to cautiously choose the proper route, avoiding the loose overhangs. It will become abruptly evident at this point there is absolutely no room for error. Being caught here during bad weather could be the last mistake of your life. Constantly shifting rock should cause groups to ascend one at a time. This drastic section gives way about 150 feet up with a side stage exit. Particular attention should be taken to remember your exit point on the rock climb section below. Confusion may develop as to where you made your ascent. With the tough section behind, a timeless viewpoint will eventually allow your hands to dry. Yet be reminded, your path of descent will constantly linger in the back of your mind. Slow, methodical steps now become the main priority. Your constant balancing act seems to demoralize you in this ravished world you have now crossed the line into. The crushed boulder landscape sloughs off the mountainside with grand views to the basin and still visible faint trail. Your deep quickening breaths will continue.
Above 14,000 feet now.
With that in mind, I sensed it was due time for an altitude adjustment. Unable to evade temptation, I was lured to peer out over the edge. Examination of the shattered rock slide and recalling the traverse through it will surely shiver one's knees. Elevated above all nearby points, priceless. The stroll towards the final upward step of the mountain lies strewn with cold, hard stone. With the summit becoming much nearer, your excitement will be sure to escalate. The small islands of tundra give way as you mount your final uphill stumble while you stage your last dance on the rock-laden path. Void of any vegetation, the high Colorado world becomes dominated by rock. Forces unimaginable, along with years uncomprehendable, have literally smashed the solid stone cap of this mighty mountain. With the tattered remains left behind, the edges of the summit slough away, forming the landscape with piles upon piles of broken rock. Several man-made stone wind shelters exist near the summit. I presume you could seek refuge inside their walls to avoid the ripping forces of the frequent storms that pound this island in the sky. The final push to the crown of a 14er will never be forgotten. Above you, only the sky stretches out. As the final rock barriers give way, and with only countable steps remaining, an unimaginable rush takes you from deep within. It is without a doubt a superior thrill to stand at the top of the San Juan Mountain Range. The sheer 800-foot drop of the North Face Wall stands balanced a half mile above the far reaches of Big Blue Canyon. A staggering stroll along the summit edge will remind you there's no way to go but down. Positively, a long way down. As Big Blue sets the stage of Rocky Mountain paradise, numerous glimpses into totally isolated areas are sure to boggle one's mind. Colorful ridges stretch down to pinnacle-laden uprises, sometimes referred to as the Cimarron Needles. Uncompaghre's huge summit boasts a unprecedented view atop a land of endless mountains. Mountain peaks stretch off in the distance, 360 degrees around you now, for as far as your mind and your eyes can see. The summit platform oversees all for 100 miles in all directions. Pushing the buttons on my camera, I took frame after frame of the beauty I was now a part of. I came to understand how people are defined by life's experiences. Even the audience of lower altitude peaks seemed to be observing my stance so high in the Colorado sky. You remain as only a brief witness atop a high mountain peak, and even the sign in canister will hold no true meaning. You attempt to absorb every moment staring out upon the vastness of all the earth that is now below you. A fear of not being able to recall every minute piece within your vision seems to draw a constant concentration. Fearless determination must remain your main priority. Yet, as you aimlessly walk around, you are constantly reminded of your temporary stay. The mountain's extreme environment will never allow you to linger long. Wandering to the far western reaches of the summit is well worthwhile. The unsurpassed view down the East Fork Cimarron Canyon can almost seem to stop time for a moment. The airy overlook perches you on top of what may be perceived as a mountaintop diving board. The 10-mile canyon is bordered on the west side by Pinnacle Ridge. The 6-mile forest of rock pinnacles end at the mouth of the canyon. The end-cap southwestern view draws your attention towards two high 13ers. Accessible from the West Fork Cimarron Valley, Coxcomb, a thin-finned outcropping, and Red Cliff with its wonderful viewing point. The unique Wetterhorn Pyramid reaches above 14,000 feet. Only 3 miles from Uncompaghre, Wetterhorn lies almost in line with Mount Sneffels, about 30 miles downrange.
Such a long way to get back to the truck. One step at a time.
To tread so near the ceiling of Colorado is a great privilege and honor. The land is so encompassing, and as a person you realize we are so small. It is truly amazing to experience High Colorado.